But it was really important to have great teachers, and that is something that Aptitude provided, and that is what attracted me towards Aptitude. And I was pretty sure after the first demo class that this is the place that I want to join. Hello everyone, my name is Ayan Gupta, and my hobbies include everything from reading to playing tennis. Apart from that, if I am not doing that, you'll probably find me watching movies and TV shows in my free time. That's how most of my free time usually goes. And I play the guitar sometimes whenever I try to find the time to play the guitar during my day, and that is something that helps me relax a lot. So I would count that as a hobby too. My school life was not concentrated to one place, but the two primary places where most of it happened was Udaipur and Gurgaon, right? And I was a part of the CBSE board, and in 11th-12th I chose commerce without maths. I had legal studies in its place, primarily out of interest. My favorite subjects from the very start, ever since the subjects of social sciences were included, I would count those as my favorites. I did not have a subject per se that I hated, but if there was something that I wasn't really good at, I would go with math. Science was more of a bittersweet thing, depending on my mood. And that's pretty much how my school life went with respect to academics. Primarily in 10th standard, there were three main career options that were in front of me. First was specifically going into academic research, with special emphasis on political science. The second option was, of course, law in front of me. The third option was management and general, the IPM exam that was there for the BBA plus MBA course. The decision itself was based on me asking myself one simple question. Out of the three things, what is the one thing that I know for a fact at this point of time I can do for the rest of my life every day after waking up? And the answer was simple: law. And that is how I finally then decided upon going ahead with law. GILLET as an exam, I would say, I wouldn't rate it as difficult, but it requires one to have a good idea about how to manage their time. That is the most important thing in ALET. So the general idea about ALET is that because of the long questions that it asks, or because of the difficult puzzles that it asks, it's a very difficult exam per se. But then if you think about it, these aren't really the questions that decide the cutoff. These are only the questions that give the toppers an edge. The cutoffs are decided by the basic and easy questions. So it's ALET, and I would say, is a very average exam. And what's important in that exam is your time management and deciding what questions to choose. The same primarily goes for CLAT, but on the relative scale, CLAT is a bit easier than ALET. But the idea behind the exams remains the same. The exams are altogether about decision making and time management, because that are two things that, as a lawyer, especially decision making as a lawyer, or in any general career nowadays, you will require. Decision making is the essence of all of these exams. Two things, in my opinion, would help somebody crack an exam like ALET and CLAT. First is an idea of what the examiner wants out of you. And the only way you can do that is by going through the previous year papers and finding a pattern in certain kinds of things. So what this will do is, this will give you a direction. Because per se, there is no syllabus. And if there was one, it would be really, really vast, right? So if you are to look at that vast syllabus or list of topics, you'll just get confused and, you know, you'll not know from where to start, because this is something that happened with me during when I started preparing. So the one thing that I did then to tackle this was figure out the direction that the examiner wants us to go in. And specifically for CLAT and ALET, that would be somewhere with good reading skills. They focus a lot on critical reasoning. And then with respect to analytical reasoning paths, it's again about time management and whether or not you can figure out what the examiner is trying to ask you from what's written. Then the second thing is knowing how to stay calm during the exam. That is the most important thing that one has to ensure that they are. If you're calm during the exam, no matter how good or bad you are at a particular section or a particular topic, you'll be able to manage it. Because when you're calm during the exam, if something goes wrong, you'll be able to figure out what your strategy should be. What should you do next to, you know, counter that or balance that problem out. So these two things will make it very easy for one to crack an exam like CLAT or ALET.